In this video, I'm going to be playing one match at every rank inside of Brawl Stars. The ranks start from Bronze and end all the way at Masters. This is going to take a while. I've got a few accounts at multiple different ranks, so that'll help a little bit. But this challenge is going to be difficult because it requires me to push to ranks that are higher than I've ever been before. I feel like it's worth mentioning that on this account, I only have Jesse leveled up. So if she gets banned or picked by someone else, I am screwed. Honestly, I don't even know if I can do this. Bronze 1 seems like a great place to start. Bronze 1 is the lowest rank possible in Power League, and it's exactly what you'd expect. Immediately, the draft is all over the place. On top of that, it feels like nobody knows what they're doing. Like, our Rosa has half of our team's gems. Why? I can't explain it. It even felt like I didn't know what I was doing for a second. Run. After that super close call we had there, we managed to win game number one. Okay, GG, easy. Game one, let's go. Game number two became increasingly more stressful. In gem grab, you usually want one person to carry all of your team's gems. But my teammates decided that they all wanted a piece of this pie. And so our gems were all over the place. That means if just one of us dies, we could very well lose this game. Please don't die. Just stay alive. Why are you dying? Why are you dying? What are you doing? Shortly after that, we get our first win of this journey. Bronze 2 and 3 were exactly the same as Bronze 1. I take Jesse, we win game, and we move on to the next rank. Silver 1 actually kind of impressed me. The draft felt really consistent with what you would find at some of the higher ranks. Not only that, but we ran into our first Power 11. This guy's got a Power 11 stew with two Perpy boys on him? Luckily for me, he was on my team. In game 1, I found myself in a 2v1 situation, and I'll just let it play out for you. I'm alone, fighting a Lola and a Beau. I'm wiggling around this rock, I have my turret in hand, and I'm trying to find some shots there, make a little bit of connection. The gas is pushing us closer together here as I recharge my turret, stun the Beau when he comes around the corner, Tom Brady the turret over the wall, get a kill onto the Beau, and Lola on 781 HP doesn't stand a chance. After gaining momentum in such a dominant fashion, we steamrolled these guys and we took this game as well. Silver 2, again, felt really, really consistent. I'm impressed. It felt like the people knew how to draft. Unfortunately, they did not know how to play. The stew on my team insisted on carrying the gems. Okay, fine. As long as you don't die, it's all right. He died with all of our gems, which is very unfortunate. If we don't shape up for game two, there is no chance that we can go undefeated in this challenge. Unfortunately, they get the best of us and they get a 2-gem lead and they have countdown. With 5 seconds left, we have to go all in and get a reset or we lose. Lucky enough for us, we get the reset. However, we all died in the process. Oh my God, dude, I think we lost this game, man. Oh my God. Yup, that was our first loss of this journey. Okay, let's see what Silver 3 has to offer here. Remember a little bit ago when I said that if someone takes Jesse, I'm pretty much screwed? Well, the worst thing you could possibly imagine actually happened. No, he took Jesse! I panicked and didn't know who to take, and I went with Nita. Let's just play Nita. I don't know. One could say that I need a pick a different brawler. Luckily for me, my teammate took a Power 9 Colt with star power and gadget. If we wanted to win, he was gonna have to carry. Our Power 10 carry's already dead. Despite our hard carry dying immediately, I found a way to pop off as a Power 1 Nita. We pretty much stomp on these guys and we win round number one. Round two might be a different story. I was on autopilot for a little bit, just running around doing Nita things, you know? And then I realized that we're losing the game. Oh, we're losing! No! Heading into the last 20 seconds, we were down by 6 points and the blue star. After a few kills, we managed to tie it up with just 2 seconds left, but we don't have the blue star and we died anyway. We didn't win game two. Oh man, Bounty is pretty boring, so I'm skipping over a lot of the gameplay, but with 1:06 left, we were up by 9 points and the blue star. Surely there's no way we could lose this. I'm just joking. Watch how fast this goes downhill. In the span of like 5 seconds, we managed to lose a 9-point lead and the blue star. With about 30 seconds left, we managed to steal the lead until our Bonnie decides to just throw it for some reason. How are you dying so much? And with 10 seconds left, we fall apart and I lose my mind. What are we doing? It really is a coin flip. After losing back-to-back games, I was pretty upset. But we are heading into a new rank, which is Gold 1, so maybe that'll bring us some better luck. I couldn't have been more wrong about that previous statement. What started this downhill spiral of chaos was the draft. What even is this draft, bro? And if you think things couldn't get any worse by having a Shelly and a Primo on your team for knockout, just wait till you see what happens next. Any way that I can... No, he took Jesse! So I went Jean, and I don't know. They're all power one, so all the brawlers suck anyway. I can't wait to get onto my next account where I actually have star powers and stuff. Jesus, man. Some of you might be thinking, well, of course you're gonna lose this game. You have a power one Jean. It's all your fault. Nope, that's just simply not true. Our Shelly runs in the bush and dies as soon as the game starts. And in knockout, if you're in a 2v1 situation, it's very difficult to win. On top of that, the Primo dies shortly after, and I'm left in a 1v3. I'm a power one and I'm the last one on my team alive. How does it make any sense? The main reason that I took Jean here was because that if I hit a pull and I have a Shelly or a Primo next to me, they can help me get the kill. And that's not what happened. To die. Oh, I missed my pull. All right, that's on me. Primo, help, help, I hit the pull. Round two was more of the same. All right, who wants to bet a brawl pass if the Shelly dies first? Good, good. How does this Shelly just always find a way to die? It's almost impressive with how bad this person is. Let's just be real, that game was not winnable. Gold 2 is where things are gonna get a lot better because this is my first account swap and now I've got star powers and gadgets and it's just gonna be so much more fun. Playing on this account gives me some versatility, but it can't stop my teammates from drafting terrible brawlers.
Gear. Oh, I think we score.
Let's go, baby. Dude, I just have to carry. Give me ball, I score. These laughs were gonna disappear soon because shortly after we scored, the opponents also fire back. I killed him and he's still, like, how is he shooting from the grave? And then honestly, they scored this second goal because our Barley just wasn't playing. Oh, the Barley's not playing. Like, oh my God, it doesn't matter. You just gotta get lucky and hope your teammates are good. Round number two was a sweaty one, and somehow our Barley, who was barely playing the entire time, scored this banger. Yes! How did he score? I don't even care. It doesn't matter. Let's go, baby. But again, our celebration was cut short because the opponents fire back very fast.
Oh my God, man.
Okay, let's speed run this. We go to overtime. Our Barley stops playing. Enemy scores. That's the end of the game.
It's unwinnable, man.
Despite having a brand new account with multiple star powers and gadgets, we still lose because of our teammates' inability to draft and play the game. So at this point, I'm on a 3-loss streak, so things really can't get much worse. We get placed on Dueling Beetles, which is one of my favorite maps, by the way, but I opt to play Squeak, because Squeak is awesome. After that team wipe, we pretty much held control for most of this game, and we win round one very, very fast. This is the part where I acknowledge how good the Jackie was on my team.
That's more than fine. All right, let's go.
We're popping off, boys! Let's go! Oh, with the mortar! Okay, I still think we win this, but shout out to my goated teammates here. We win this game, and now we're moving on to Diamond. We're with the big boys now. Heading into Diamond 1, I was nervous because it feels like people just take their highest power level brawler instead of the brawlers that are actually good on that map. Anyway, I found one crucial secret tip that's gonna help us win this game.
All right, perfect posture makes the perfect player, boys. Come on.
In the very first round of this game, I found myself in a 1v1 situation. Oh, he's stunned. Yeet. Easy money, baby. Let's go. Give me that ISO. And because of my perfect posture, I was able to clutch up round number one. Round two, however, was a bit of a different story.
No.
We got wiped almost instantly, and then our B could not 1v3, obviously, so we did lose round number two. It was all up to this. Heading into round three, we needed to play perfect. Our B died pretty much as soon as round started. And then my Jesse walks directly into a Brock shot, and it was pretty much over from there. Is game number two where we're gonna be able to come back? I don't know. Game number two, we start off hot, and we pick up a quick first round victory. And we kill him.
Okay, nice job. Let's go.
And in round number two, we go sicko mode. Our Jesse absolutely outplays the Stew, and our B gets to tap in on Squeak, and we tie it up 1-1. Let's go, boys! Game number three does not start off good for your boy. This Squeak, for some reason, is using the longer range gadget.
Play. Squeak's already used two gadgets. It was a good play.
When the other slow zoning gadget is just better. No one ever uses the range one. And after I die, do you really expect my teammates to be able to clutch up?
Egg.
We're down 1-0, and if we lose this, we lose the entire game. I'm not gonna lie, Knockout's pretty boring up until the later stages of the game. That's where all the action is. And speaking of action, our Jesse gets dashed on by the Stew and goes down. It's a tough spot to be in a 2v3. However, we do manage to fleece the Squeak. Stepping on the bow mine, we manage to kill the Squeak. B kills the Brock, and we're in a 2v1 situation. Stew dashes onto the B, and me, with 1500 HP, blunders.
No! Oh my god, I couldn't get away! That was a good game.
And unfortunately, we lose that game. After that heartbreaking loss, we were on to Diamond 2, where we get put on Snake Prairie, and I make the worst pick of my entire life. Our teammate then takes Janet, and halfway through the match, I realize that he's not using the correct star power. How are you not using the star power that shows the bushes? You see, Janet's got a star power where when you're flying through the air like your Buzz Lightyear, all of the bushes get revealed, which is very useful for this map, as you could imagine. Unfortunately, we go on to lose game one.
All right, game one goes to the bad guys.
Game two does not start off great. Our teammates are shooting each other and putting thumbs down emotes, and it's just absolute chaos.
No!
I'm impressed with my opponents here because they actually know what they're doing in terms of like sitting back and like they know they're winning so that we have to come to them pretty much. Like, look at how nice it would be to have all of the enemies revealed here. But I pick up a kill, so it doesn't matter because I'm a god.
Yes! Let's go, baby! Woo!
After that, I might have made the best Brawl Stars play of my entire career.
Oh my god, I'm popping off! Oh my god, go crazy!
After making the best play of my career, I might have made the worst play of my career. I got a little too confident and made a big mistake. How does it hit me for 1345? Regardless of my death, with 20 seconds left, we're still up by 3 points.
Bro, not the best here for us, I'm not gonna lie.
No, how are we losing? How did we lose? I've lost in Diamond 1 and 2, so will Diamond 3 be any different? So we're hopping into the draft on Safe Zone, and my teammates have taken Penny and Belle. Note that this is before the Penny buff, so at this point, Penny still kind of sucks. So then I opted to play Daryl, because if I've learned anything throughout my history of Power League, it's that when you play Heist, you just pick a brawler that does a ton of damage to the safe, and you do everything yourself. Unfortunately, our opponents know how to counter us, and they take Pam, and that makes me want to cry. For example, take a look at this push right here. I notice that we're down by a lot, and so I roll in as Daryl, and just watch. I did 40% by myself, and we still lost.
Bell, shoot the Colt! Why? Just shoot the Colt!
Game two starts off really, really good for us. We pick up 2 kills and we're looking perfect.
Pam used all of her... Oh my god!
A little 3K. Not bad. Not bad. That was like 20%. That's good. That's what we're supposed to be doing.
Hey, this is good. We roll. Oh, let's go, baby.
Anyways, 15 seconds left. We're down by like 17% or something. So we're going to have to pop off here.
Come on, guys. I did so much damage.
I really lost in Diamond 1, 2, and 3. Jesus, man. As we climb our way through the higher ranks, I can't help but feel more and more nervous for each match. And Mythic 1 was no different. We load in the Hot Potato, and I decide to go with the tried and true Jesse pick. The first thing I notice about Mythic is that everyone has super high level brawlers, which my teammates were not happy about. So far, noticeably more sweaty than the previous games.
I just feel like we have what we need to win. We're just not using it correctly.
Match number two is crucial. If we lose this, we lose the game. Our team composition has crazy output damage. Like, once we get into the base and we get some DPS on,
We're gonna be good. Don't mind me, boys. Just 2v1ing on defense. No big deal. Like, look at this push. It's not even that good. And we did like 30-something percent and we took the lead. Although this game is still really close. It's not over yet. Oh, wait. Byron's dead. Big damage from me. I think we actually win this game. Oh my God, we won. Dude, see? I feel like what a lot of heist players at like the mythic range don't do is get damage. A minute or so into game number three, I realized that our Barley was playing so much better. Dude, our Barley, he's stepping up big. Look at this. I'm going crazy right now on control. Oh my God, look at my teammates. Look what happens when they shoot the vault. Brilliant. So if one of your teammates plays bad, it's a really common trend at some of the higher ranks to add them as a friend after the match and then invite them to a lobby and then talk smack to them in more derogatory terms, but you guys get it. I wanted to do things differently. I thought Kapow played pretty well and I wanted to shed some light on that. So after the game, I added him as a friend and I invited him to a lobby just to say, yo, you played pretty good. His first message was asking me if it was my second account, which yeah, it was. I then explained that I was doing a video where I play a game at every rank. Note that he does not know who I am at the moment. And then it clicks and he says, wait, are you McD's? And then he says he watches all my videos and explained that he recognized this account name from one of my videos with Wasim, which is cute and hilarious. And this guy was really nice. I think Mythic 2 is really going to be a turning point for us here because Mythic 2 on my main account now where I have every brawler power 11 and gears out the wazoo. We get put on one of my favorite maps, which is Ring of Fire. My teammates are drafting well and the opponents also had a decent draft, so this is going to be a competitive match. Our two teammates pick up two kills and then I died, but then they got two more kills and they're just going sicko mode. In the bush. All right, Sandy's got a storm now, so that's not great. I don't like that, but hopefully playing around the Pam turret here should be good for us. Unfortunately, the opponents were able to mount a bit of a comeback. However, thanks to a team wipe from my two teammates doing all the work, we were able to get control again and win this game. Game two, I was electric. No pun intended because it's Bell, but I really felt like that I couldn't miss a shot even. Mythic 3. This is arguably the rank where I spend most of my Power League seasons. The biggest difference that I've noticed from Diamond to Mythic is that the draft is so much more consistent. Like in Diamond, everyone had their brawlers leveled up, but no one was taking the correct brawlers for whatever map we were on. But in Mythic, it feels like everyone's got high power levels, but also they're drafting very, very well. Anyway, this is our team comp. That is their team comp. Let's get into this. The start of this game was beautiful. I'm just gonna let it play out for you. Game, how we not score? He's not even playing, he just quits. He's like, yeah, you know what? I wish round number two was more competitive, but it wasn't. After a pretty clean goal from your boy here, we had one close call that we dealt with. After that, we just scored another goal and that was the end of the game. Yeah, let's go, baby. Woo! Pushing through some of these higher ranks actually takes a lot of time. Plus, that's why this video took forever to make and I was sick for 2 weeks and whatever. After a few hours of pushing, I got to Legend 1 and this is one rank below my highest ever rank. We load in and unfortunately, we got knockout. Yup, that's right. The meme lord himself is on our team. After seeing the name of a Brawl Stars god on my team, I had all the confidence in the world. And even worse than the Mortis pick, Coach Corey is using the jump gadget for some reason. Why? Why, Corey? Anyway, in this match, our Mortis dies, I pick up a kill, and then I get scammed from my super. I was so close to getting it, and you guys can see me shoot backwards, and I thought I had my super, and I was gonna be able to escape, and anyway, we lose the round, but it's not over yet. Because our Mortis opens up this match with a double kill and pretty much secures the round for us as soon as it starts. Huge plays from him. And then there's no way that we lose a 2v1. So we're on to round number three. After a few slick taps from your boy, we really opened up the game for our Mortis to dive in there and just wipe the opponents clean. I don't think he's using jump on purpose, or maybe he is and he's a lunatic, but... Yes, let's go, baby. I farm a kill onto the Gene.
Coach Corey does the swaggiest thing I've ever seen him do. And then Mortis kills a tick, and that's the end of the first round. This round was over before it started. Our Mortis dives in there, gets one kill, weakens tick. I pick up the other kill. Corey drops a super onto Gene's forehead, and I mean, this is just the end of the game. After days of pushing and being stuck in Legendary 1, I finally made it to Legendary 2. Heading into the match, we get put on Heist, and if you guys don't know my strategy, I just take Daryl or a tank and I try and do as much vault damage as possible. And this game is no different. I lock in Daryl with the last pick, and we were on our way to glory. This game is no longer PvP. This is strictly PvE. Okay, I just gotta hammer away at the vault. That's all there is to it. I need to get onto the opposing team's vault. That's really all I need to do. Go, go, huge, go, pump, do damage. Just do as much okay, nice, nice. I think we win. You think this strategy doesn't work, but watch this push. We haven't gotten damage, but neither have they, so. Knocking the Colonel Ruffs into the bow mine, and we've already done 50% on one push. All around, very well played from my teammates. Just a perfect game, let's go. For some reason, I thought Byron was a good last pick, and now after looking at this footage, I should have just taken Gale so that we couldn't get countered. And then our opponents take him, and sick Connor brain is like, oh yeah, it's not that bad. Shut up. That was terrible. I blame it on me being sick, and you cannot convince me otherwise. I'm not gonna lie, our Rico was going insano style. And then we probably could have finished off this game sooner, but the Gale bopped our Rico over the wall somehow. And then unfortunately, they kind of jammed the ball down our throat and score. Unfortunately, we leave the Leon alone in lane, and he comes up invisible, kills me, and then they score. So nothing really you could do about that. Our Frank thought that I could outheal all of the opponents on the other team, shooting him at the same time. It's not how it works. I don't know. And then I find myself in a shootout. It feels like I'm taking a penalty kick here in FIFA, and he saves it, of course. I feel like I could have walked that in, honestly. And with our Frank getting melted over and over again, there's just no way to win this match. Masters, the single highest rank in all of Brawl Stars. Thousands of players try to get this prestigious rank every single season, and many of them fail. And I'm one of those people. I didn't get it. But I'll do you one better. I'm bringing in celebrity guest, professional Brawl Stars player, Bobby BS, who's gonna showcase us a Masters game, and we're gonna be able to see it in all of its glory. Bobby.
Yo, Connor, the handsome best Brawl Stars player of all time, number one YouTuber of all time in Brawl Stars. Hello, how are you doing, bro?
that's what people call me.
All right, so yeah, with the current situation of the draft, you know, we have a bow and a level 9 Piper, so it's not looking too good, so I'm just gonna, you know.
Oh, the dairy?
Yeah. I don't know if it's just...
Oh, no.
Holy penny. Please, Bo. Okay.
Bobby's going rogue, boys. That's why I'm not a big bounty person because of that.
Yeah, like, you see this current position right here is not... Yeah, see...
Wait, go...
Please, Penny?
Oh, you didn't even kill that penny?
No. Alright.
Oh, no. Alright, game two. Let's... Wait, does it still say defeat and... Oh, I guess it doesn't matter.
Please? Okay. Alright, there we go.
Oh!
There
we go. Okay, not bad. Uh-oh. Oh!
Okay, I mean... Okay,
oh, that was sick.
Worked out. Come on.
Yeah, that was clean.
Come on, just don't die, Bo. Oh, I mean, okay, we got the lead.
That mortar's not great. Also, your bow's getting a little reckless. Oh, dude, he's kind of tapping, though. I'm not gonna lie. This guy's fragging out.
He's getting killed.
Oh my god!
Reckless. Oh, this is not good. Oh, this is not good. 9 HP.
Surge has 9
please,
HP.
Please,
Surge has
9. One shot. Just one shot is all I ask. Please?
Oh my god.
No!
There's two seconds.
Oh my god. Not really trying to like kill them. I mean, I guess I did kill
them. My.
Okay.
Oh, dude, the pennies are weak. Okay, nice. You get to the lead, so.
Oh, good shot.
Oh, okay. Now you're still up by one. This is fine. Okay, wait. Piper is eating mortar shots. Uh-oh.
Man.
Oh, no. There's still 10 seconds and you have your roll.
Oh.
Wait.
Give me a shot. Oh my god. I can't get out though. No.
No. Everyone say bye to the Brawl Pass.
No way.
All right, everyone like and subscribe. See you later. Thanks for watching.